Voltage amplifier, as we saw earlier, is nothing more than a voltage-controlled current source. You apply a voltage to the input to get a current. That current is injected to an output resistance, forcing the voltage across it to be a scaled version of the input. Today we will talk about one of those devices that can work as a voltage-controlled current source. Bipolar junction transistor, simply BJT. For a resistor, the voltage-current relationship is linear. The current is the voltage of a resistance. Increasing the voltage across the resistor increases the current linearly. Current source, on the other hand, is a device that delivers constant current no matter what the voltage across it. The current is not sensitive to the voltage across it, unlike resistance. Voltage-controlled current source is a current source delivering a current proportional to some other voltage in the circuit. The current is not sensitive to the voltage across it. It depends on some other voltage in the circuit. Voltage-controlled current source takes voltage as input and produces output current depending only on the input voltage. Bipolar junction transistor is a three terminals device: the base, the collector, and the emitter. If we manage to make the voltage VCE larger than VBE, then the BJT is working in the forward active region and can be seen as a voltage-controlled current source. The output current, or the current flowing from the collector to the emitter, is governed by this equation. As the base emitter voltage is kept constant, the current from the collector to the emitter is constant value that doesn't depend on the collector emitter voltage. A voltage-controlled current source whose value depends only on VBE, IS, and VT are constant. A small change in the base emitter voltage is able to change the collector current substantially. Exponential relationship. At the same time, changing the collector emitter voltage has no effect on the collector current. Front view and side view shows the relationship of the output current versus VBE and VCE. These graphs are valid only for the forward active region. We will see the whole picture in the next video. So IC can be modeled as a current source with constant value determined by VBE no matter what VCE is. A voltage controlled current source. Not only that, there is a small amount of current flows from the base to emitter, the base current. The relationship between the base current and the collector current is linear. Collector current is a scaled version of the base current. Beta is called current gain, implying that the collector current is an amplified version of the base current. Substituting the collector current equation, then the base current is also varying exponentially with the base emitter voltage. Unlike the collector current, the base current depends on the voltage across it, so we can't consider it as a current source. It looks like a resistor whose current is changing exponentially with respect to the voltage across it. A nonlinear resistor. We know that diode is a nonlinear resistor whose current is varying exponentially with respect to the voltage across it. The base current is equal to that of a diode having a reverse saturation current of IS over beta. So it feels like there is a diode between the base and emitter, forcing the base current to be exponentially related to VBE. So the whole model of BJT is a diode between the base and emitter, forcing the base current to be exponentially related to VBE, and the current source between the collector and emitter whose value is equal to the base current scaled by a factor of beta. This is called the large signal model. Each time you find a BJT in the circuit, you can replace it with this model. Most of the time we deal with small input signals. That enables us to work with a simple version of that model, the small signal model, which we will cover in the next tutorial. Since the base and collector currents are flowing into the emitter current is the sum of both. The base current is too small compared to the collector current, so it can be neglected, and hence emitter and collector currents are equal. So BJT is a voltage to current converter. It takes the base emitter voltage and converts it to a collector current. That current can be injected into a large resistor to get an amplified voltage across it, a scaled version of the input voltage. That's what a voltage amplifier is all about.